First of all, Marvin, welcome back. How does it feel to be back in national team colours training camp before CONCACAF Gold Cup qualifier?
Thank you, and it's definitely an honour to be back in. You know, unfortunately, I had some mishaps in the previous tour, but it's always glad, and I'm always glad to be here, and it's an honour to be here.
Right. Not mission impossible, because we've been here before. We've had to qualify for CONCACAF Gold Cup. With all that experience under your belt, previous Gold Cup campaigns, what's the desire like inside of you to make sure we're there yet another time?
The desire is fully well there. You know, as I said in a previous interview to you some years ago, this tournament is the second highest tournament for us. Other than the World, we all know World Cup is the highest. This is the second highest for us in this region, CONCACAF Gold Cup, you know. It's just for us to go there and apply ourselves in these qualifiers, take it game by game, and to do our best to get to the wrong situation.
A different scenario now in terms of the setup for the coaching staff. Angus Eve is now at the helm. You would have known Angus over the years. How much are you looking forward now to being part of this whole this team under his leadership?
I think he started off well, you know, in getting everyone to play the way that he wants. Everyone is not in camp as yet, but with the local guys, he's definitely getting a good response in terms of getting what he wants from us.
Right. What does it mean to you to be part of a team that is trying to now rebound from the disappointment of a World Cup qualifying exit? You know, it's a new chapter. We've been through this before already, Marvin, where we've come to the end of what I would say maybe failed campaigns, not qualifying for World Cups. And now we have an opportunity to be part of something, you know, that hopefully will put us back on the map. It's going to be a long road, but definitely being part of it.
I think, you know, going out in the World Cup qualifiers like the way we did, it's definitely heartbroken to us, to the country. And I know the onus is us and players now to bring back our football to a level, to a much respected level across the region, and to have the fans back on our side.
What was it like for you? I mean, the recent period, World Cup qualifying, you know, we didn't come out of it as we would have liked. It was difficult. There were a lot of trying times. is that a part of your career you're looking to put a close on, you know, and ensure that we don't get back into something like that?
Well, definitely I had high hopes, you know, definitely wanting to qualify for a World Cup, you know. Unfortunately, it didn't happen as a player. Hopefully someday I could be at a World Cup level as a coach. So it definitely hurts not being there as a player.
Yeah, good. Gold Cup, tell us about it. Why is it important for us to be there? You've been to Gold Cups before. You were part of the class two teams that got to quarterfinals under Stephen Hart. And it must be something that you're excited about, that you want to be part of.
As I said, you know, this is the second highest tournament for us in this region, you know, and this tournament is an exceptional tournament, you know. I've been here, this is my fifth year here, you know, so we're just here. I'm just here to do the best I can and also to pass on my expertise to the younger ones and learn my experience.
What is going to be the key for us now to get through these two qualifying games? First, we have to get past Montserrat and then look to another qualifier against the winner of French Guiana and Cuba.
Well, we definitely need to take it game by game, you know. Montserrat is next, so we need to prepare for Montserrat. So we definitely need to work hard. We need to stick together. We need to definitely follow the tactics and game plans the coach have, and we'll be all right.
So far in Boca Raton here with the team, a few days training sessions, how have things been in the camp?
Definitely, it's a good vibes. It definitely is a good vibes and good camaraderie. Everybody vying for a spot, you know. It's tough outside there on the training pitch, you know, and all these things could just augur well going in towards the game.
Right. What keeps Marvin going? I mean, you're getting on in age, but goalkeepers have a longer time span than the average player. Do you feel fitter? Do you have that desire to continue playing? Where can we see you in maybe 6 months to a year?
definitely, I definitely do feel fit. I definitely feel good at the moment, you know, but what kept me going was trying to qualify for a World Cup. Well, I'm here now with the Gold Cup squad, so we'll see how it goes after the Gold Cup.
All right, Marvin, all the best to you. Thank you.
Thank you.